Oh, right, Blair. Yeah, I see. Nice.
I theme my germs. Makes them more fun.
Cool. Very cool.
Do you like jam?
Yep.
Yes. Sometimes I feel like I could do with a friend out here.
Yeah, it's good to have a friend.
Have a proper taste.
Suck mummy's finger? Do I suck the finger?
Good?
Very good. I mean, I've got a girlfriend.
Try the Diana Memorial Strawberry.
Okay, I'm finger sucking. Is this wrong? Maybe this is totally normal. Maybe this is what they do in the country. Good.
You like it, don't you?
Yes, I do like it.
Try this.
Maybe she just likes having her fingers sucked. I mean, I don't mind, but eventually it's gonna get cloying.
I expect you've noticed that Ian's a little older than me. He used to enjoy doing lots of things that he doesn't like doing anymore.
No, yeah, I'm sure.
So, there you are. I'm a woman.
Indeed.
And you're a man.
Technically, yes.
So, what are you going to do about that?
Okay, it's not gonna be just the jam. So what am I gonna do? It's almost like a moral decision, but not really, 'cause no one will find out.
Goodbye, beard. Hello, familiar, stupid face.
So, how'd it go down the pub? Make a good impression?
I think so. But it got me thinking about Sophie and the wedding and how I probably don't properly love her.
Yeah?
Yes. I think I'm going to call it off, Jez.
Wow, that's... I'm impressed, Mark. Could go for a high five. Probably not the most appropriate time. So, is that why the beard?
Yes.
I thought you liked the beard.
Well, I had to pretend that even to myself. I mean, what sort of man would grow an unwanted beard to order?
So, when are you going to call it off?
I don't know, it's difficult. I mean, ideally it would be somewhere with nice surroundings.
Yeah.
Somewhere with flowers, coffee, and sedatives, medical assistance. Maybe with music, but not too jaunty, melancholy music.
Right, so where are you planning to find this magical musical breakup hospital?
Shit. That'll be Sophie looking for Nookie. I can't see her now. Pretend to be asleep.
Why don't you just finish it now?
I can't do it now. You don't just declare war, Jeremy. You prime the press, you square the UN, you make up your reasons. Snore.
What?
Heard you snoring, but you're not asleep.
No, just practicing. I was showing Jeremy some techniques.
I'm sure Jeremy's got plenty of his own techniques. I just wanted to check you were back okay, Mark, and say how lovely it is to have you both here.
Please, no. Please tell me no.
What?
That, the smutty smile. Jeremy, please tell me that nothing's going on there.
Nothing is going on there.
Let's just say that nothing is going on there.
Yeah. Actually, I did want to tell someone. I mean, it was so cool. She had all this jam.
Oh my God, you didn't! You fucked her! Jeremy, you need chemical castration. You're out of control. That's Sophie's mother.
She's hot.
She's not out of Hollyoaks, Jeremy. She's probably out of ration book. Oh, you're a piece of work, aren't you? I'm down the pub putting the hours in with the dad, and you're back in the house banging the mum. That is not a good impression.
I don't know. I think I made a pretty good impression.
Jeremy, please, don't smile like that. You're not James Bond. You're disgusting.
I am James Bond.
I'm sorry you have to be out here with me watching this. Just me walking about, basically. Penny wanted us out of the house, and what Penny wants, Penny gets.
No, it's fine. I mean, if I wasn't here, I'd just be sitting around with Soph, and I can see her any time.
So come on, Mark. Why haven't you told her yet?
Shh, can he hear?
He can't hear. Can you, you big fox-hunting, badger-baiting, tweed-shirt, bumfuck homophobe? Oh, shit!
Bottle cap. Another one for the collection.
So come on, are you having second thoughts?
I don't know. Maybe. I mean, she's so nice. So what if I don't really love her? Charles didn't really love Diana, and they were all right. Sort of.
You don't really love Sophie?
What? No?
That's what you said.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
No, no, because of distortion. There was probably a buzz that there might be an ancient Saxon coin right here.
Stop it, Mark. I heard every word. For the record, Jeremy, I may be a homophobe, but I'm no badger beta.
So, I like your barn, Ian.
It's full of crap no one has any use for. Maybe that's why I feel so at home here. Huh. Mark, if you don't love Sophie, you shouldn't marry her.
Yes, that's what I've actually been thinking. That's what I'm gonna tell her.
The good impression thermometer is reaching absolute zero.
For what it's worth, I'm sorry.
You know what? I'm glad. I'd rather you came clean now than start something that's not right. That actually takes balls.
Well, thank you.
Sometimes I wish I had the guts to say something. Do something. What would you do if you were trapped in a loveless marriage? If you knew your wife was cheating on you?
Shit!
You know what? I'd probably just leave it. Let it slide. So, what's the best bit of metal you've ever detected?
I know my wife. And I know who the culprit is, Jeremy.
Oh my God, that's why he brought us out here. He's gonna kill me. Can you kill someone with a metal detector?
Ian, I just want to say that I know that people can be very stupid and selfish, but it's our fast food culture of instant gratification you should be angry with, not...
Dan. Fucking Dan Walker.
Oh, thank you, Dan, whoever you are.
Penny's probably been doing his curtains all day. Out you lot go, I'm ramming Dan. Oh, yeah, it was Ramadan at his place today. But he's no Muslim.
Dan, what a filthy...
Maybe it's time I did something. Show Dan who the Lord of the Manor is around here. What do you think?
Well, maybe we should just...
Yeah, let's get Dan. Punish Dan.
There it is. Dan's barn.
Or you could just post something negative on the internet or blank him in the post office. That would send out a pretty horrible message.
This is the law of the jungle. This is an eye for an eye.
And you're sure you're poking the right man in the eye?
Light it.
Well, this is not what I expected. You think you'll be playing Simpson's Monopoly, and you end up an arsonist. Still, at least it's not me he's trying to incinerate.
What was all that about? Trying to get him to poke me in the eye? Let him poke Dan in the eye.
Right, so instead of you facing up to your responsibilities, poor old Dan's gonna wake up with his barn burnt, saying goodbye to his no-claims bonus.
Look, stop moaning. We're out with a man who owns guns. You're chucking his daughter, and I've screwed his wife. Tonight is going, if a bit weird, extremely fucking well for us.
I suppose you're right. Plus, maybe burning stuff is not normal, but less of a big deal out here than it is in a major conurbation.
Exactly. I nick your milk, you burn my barn.
Like scrumping for apples.
That'll teach him to put his dick where it's not wanted.
Yeah, take that, Barney.
Oh, God, I'm a fire starter. A twisted fire starter.
You ready for your big birthday surprise?
Yeah.
Keep up, everybody.
I'm a motherfucker. That's literally what I am.
Happy birthday. I hope it'll be a memorable day.
Of course it's going to be memorable. The day she's humiliated and broken in front of her family.
So what happened with the beard? We didn't get a chance to speak.
Oh, that. Well, when I was shaving, I sort of slipped and I tried evening it out, but it just got smaller and smaller until I looked like an evil overlord, so I just lost it.
Oh, the new look.
I know.
Yes, your jurisdiction over my face is hereby rescinded. Shit. But can I really break it to her? Should I? I mean, she's lovely. She's attractive. She does irritate me, but everyone irritates me.
So I was wondering if you'd listen to my track. Probably shit, but you could smoke a joint and it might sound alright.
Mm-hmm. Great.
So it must be amazing, London. What's it like down the King's Road?
Oh, cool. It's got a prep. It's got a Virgin Express, it's got a Gap, and a massive Cafe Nero.
Cool.
He thinks I'm his way into the music biz. Forget it. Music's full.
Ta-da!
Nana's cottage.
It's yours. And Mark's. To do whatever you want with.
Oh, Mum!
Oh, my God. Nana probably needs...
Oh, right, Blair. Yeah, I see. Nice.
I theme my germs. Makes them more fun.
Cool. Very cool.
Do you like jam?
Yep.
Yes. Sometimes I feel like I could do with a friend out here.
Yeah, it's good to have a friend.
Have a proper taste.
Suck Mummy's finger? Do I suck the finger?
Good?
Mmm. Very good. I mean, I've got a girlfriend.
Try the Diana Memorial Strawberry.
Okay, I'm finger sucking. Is this wrong? Maybe this is totally normal. Maybe this is what they do in the country. Good.
You like it, don't you?
Yes, I do like it.
Try this.
Maybe she just likes having her fingers sucked. I mean, I don't mind, but eventually it's going to get cloying.
I expect you've noticed that Ian's a little older than me. He used to enjoy doing lots of things that he doesn't like doing anymore.
No, yeah, I'm sure.
So, there you are. I'm a woman.
Indeed.
And you're a man.
Technically, mm-hmm, yes.
So what are you going to do about that?
Okay, it's not going to be just the jam. So what am I going to do? It's almost like a moral decision, but not really, because no one will find out.
Goodbye, beard. Hello, familiar, stupid face.
So, how'd it go down the pub? Did it make a good impression?
Yeah, I think so. But it got me thinking about Sophie and the wedding and how I probably don't properly love her.
Yeah?
Yes. I think I'm going to call it off, Jez.
Wow, that's... I'm impressed, Mark. Could go for a high five. Probably not the most appropriate time. So, is that why the beard?
Yes.
I thought you liked the beard.
Well, I had to pretend that, even to myself. I mean, what sort of man would grow an unwanted beard to order?
So, when are you going to call it off?
I don't know, it's difficult. I mean, ideally it would be somewhere with nice surroundings.
Yeah.
Somewhere with flowers, coffee, and sedatives, medical assistance. Maybe with music, but not too jaunty, melancholy music.
Right. So where are you planning to find this magical musical break-up hospital?
Oh, shit. That'll be Sophie looking for Nookie. I can't see her now. Pretend to be asleep.
Why don't you just finish it now?
I can't do it now. You don't just declare war, Jeremy. You prime the press, you square the UN, you make up your reasons. Snore.
What?
I heard you snoring, but you're not asleep.
No, just